Hey everyone, my name is Shrishti Roy from Electrical and Electronics Department of Assam Don Bosco University. Today in this short presentation, I'm going to talk about speciality fibers and its applications. Throughout this presentation, I'm going to talk about the speciality fibers and its types with a brief details on the erbium tube speciality fibers with its behavior and applications. Starting off with the introduction, optical fiber communications have changed our lives over the last 40 years. Optical fibers are making an impact and serious commercial inroads in other fields besides communications, such as in industrial sensing, biomedical laser delivery system, military gyro sensors, as well as automotive lighting and control. The requirement imposed by the broad variety of these new applications have resulted in the evolution of a new subset of custom tailored optical fiber, commonly known as the speciality fibers, which have their material and structure properties modified to render them with new properties and characteristics. Speciality fibers are designed by changing fiber glass composition, refractive index profile, and coating to achieve certain unique properties and functionalities. Types of speciality fibers. First is the erbium doped fibers, which is commercially available since the early 1990s, works best in the range of 1530 to 1565 nanometer. Gain is up to 30 dB. Next is the photosensitive fiber. The core of the photosensitive optical fiber has been created using dopants such as germanium. Photosensitive fibers are used for writing of long period grating and FBGs. FBG is used to increase optical fiber transmission capacity. Next is the band insensitive fibers. Optical fiber is sensitive to stress, particularly bending. When stressed by bending, light in the outer part of the core is no longer guided in the core of the fiber, so some is lost. Coupled from the core is cladding, created a high loss in the stress section of the fiber. Next come the termination fibers. Optical devices which have multi-ports are often have one or more open branches. So back reflection from these ports causes instabilities, which are need to be suppressed. In these cases, termination fibers are used. Example, coreless silica construction. Polarization maintaining fibers. Polarization maintaining fibers is an optical fiber in which the polarization of linearly polarized light waves launched into the fiber is maintained during propagation with little or no cross-coupling of optical power between the polarization modes. Next comes the high-index fibers. Corning Incorporated produces this types of fiber, which is patented outside vapor deposition process, providing consistency and uniformity. The fiber also features good geometry control, high core index of refraction, efficient coupling, and high numerical aperture. Lastly, the photonic crystal fibers. Photonic crystal fibers use internal microstructures to guide light through them. There are three types of photonic crystal fibers. First is the silica solid core, which have all silica fiber with a solid core. Next, hollow core, which have all silica fiber with a hollow core. And lastly, the liquid crystal field photonic crystal fibers. Erbium doped fiber. Erbium doped fiber are used within erbium doped fiber amplifiers. Since the early use of optical fiber communication network, designers have seen a need for optical amplifier as an alternative technique for longer distance transmission, along with the higher power transmitters, higher sensitivity receivers, and lower loss fibers. Erbium doped fiber amplifiers are boost optical signals and eliminate need for inefficient conversion of optical signals to electrical signals. Erbium doped fiber amplifiers were commercially available since the early 1990s. The new generation erbium doped fiber include power amplifier, preamplifier and inline amplifier for CNL bands. Next comes the interior design of an erbium doped fiber, which have a pump laser, WDM fiber coupler, erbium doped fiber loop, and a fiber input and output. A pump optical signal is added to an input signal by a WDM coupler. Within a length of doped fiber, part of the pump energy is transferred to the input signal by stimulated emission. For operation criteria, 1550 nanometer, the fiber dopant is erbium. Pump wavelength is 1980 nanometer or 1480 nanometer. Pump power criteria is 50 milliwatt. Gain of 40 to 30 dB is possible. Erbium doped fibers consist of a short section of fiber, has a small control amount of the rare earth element erbium added to the glass in form of an ion, Er3+. The principle involved is the principle of a laser. When an erbium ion is in a high energy state, a photon of light is stimulated it to give up some of its energy and return to a lower energy, more stable state, known as the stimulated emission. The laser diode in the diagram generates a power high powered between 10 to 200 milliwatt beam of light at a wavelength such that the erbium ions will absorb it and jump to their excited state. Next is the operation of an erbium doped fiber. A relatively high powered beam of light is mixed with the input signal using a wavelength selective coupler. The mixed light is guided into a section of fiber with erbium ions included in the core. This high-powered light beam excites the erbium ion to their higher energy state. When the photon belonging to the signal at a different wavelength from the pump light meet the excited erbium ion, the erbium atoms gives up some of their energy to the signal and return to their lower energy state. A significant point is that the erbium gives up its energy in form of an additional photon, which are exactly in the same phase as direction as the signal being amplified. There is usually an isolator placed at the output to prevent reflections returning from the attached fiber. Such reflections disrupt amplifier operation and in the extreme case can cause the amplifier to become a laser. Next comes the technical characteristics of an erbium doped fiber. There are a number of technical characteristics. First is the efficient pumping, then minimal power polarization sensitivity, lower insertion loss, high output power. This is not gain but raw amount of possible output power. Low noise, very high sensitivity, low distortion, and minimal inter-channel crosstalk. Amplified spontaneous emission. Erbium randomly emits photon between 1520 and 1570 nanometer. So spontaneous emission is not polarized or coherent. Like any photon, spontaneous emission stimulates emission of other photons. With no input signal, eventually all optical energy is consumed into amplified spontaneous emission. Input signals consume metastable electrons such as amplified spontaneous emissions. Next comes the erbium doped fiber behavior at gain saturation. There are two main differences between the behavior of an electronic amplifier and of erbium doped fibers in gain saturation. First is the as input power is increased on the erbium doped fiber, the total gain of the amplifier increases slowly. An electronic amplifier operates relatively linearly until its gain saturates and then it just produces all it can. This means that an electronic amplifier operates near saturation, introduces significant distortion into the signal. It just clips the peak off. Next is An erbium amplifier at saturation simply implies less gain to all of its input regardless of an instantaneous signal level. Thus, it does not distort the signal. There is little or no crosstalk between WDM channel even in saturation. The total output power is equal to amplified signal plus noise. The amplifier length. As the signal travels across the length of an amplifier, it becomes stronger due to amplification. As the pump power travels through the amplifier, its level decreases due to absorption. Thus, both the signal power level and the pump power level vary along the length of the amplifier. At any point, we can have only finite number of erbium ions, and therefore we can only achieve a finite gain and a finite maximum power per unit length of the amplifier. In an amplifier designed for a single wavelength operation, the optimal amplifier length is a function of the signal power, the pump power, the erbium concentration, and the amount of gain required. In an amplifier designed for multi-wavelength operation, there is another consideration: the flatness of the gain curve over the range of amplified wavelengths. With a careful design and optimization of the amplifier's length, we can produce a nearly flat amplifier gain curve. The optical gain of an erbium doped fibers. G is equal to S output by S input. S output means the optical signal without noise from amplifier, and S input is the input signal. Input signal is dependent, and operating point, which is the saturation of the erbium doped fiber amplifier, strongly depends on power and wavelength of incoming signal. Next is the applications of erbium doped fibers. Corning offers erbium doped fibers with hermetic coatings for significant advantage with respect to mechanical reliability and resistance to hydrogen-induced optical attenuation degradation. These erbium doped fibers have proven track record in state-of-the-art optical fiber amplifiers and exhibit consistently low splice loss, which when coupled with the fibers such as Corning HI 1060 FLEX, Corning HI 980, and Corning SMF -28E optical fiber. Single and multi-channel optical amplifiers is also an application of an erbium doped fiber. Then digital and analog system and community antenna television amplifier. Some of the products are ER1550C3, ER1550C3LC, ER1600L3, and RCER1550C3. Lastly, conclusion. Optical fibers have evolved from being simply a common transport waveguide for communication applications to become vital optical components within optical amplifiers, chromatic dispersion compensators, polarizers, sensors, and numerous other devices. A substantial portion of the Speciality Fiber filter business comes from fast-growing military aerospace applications such as fiber optic gyroscope, fiber-guided tethered missiles, and submarine hydrophones, to name a few, as well as oil and gas applications. The specialty optical fiber market grew from boutique business in the 1990s to an impressive $239 million market in 2000. Continued dynamic expansion at a rate of more than 30% per year is expected to reach global market of approximately $4.38 billion in 2010. Thank you for watching this presentation.